When I was 4 years old, my favorite movie was The Incredibles. I loved movies, but The Incredibles took the cake. You could not catch me on any given day without my Dash outfit on. So you can imagine, when my favorite food, when McDonald's came out with an Incredibles themed Happy Meal, I will never forget the Christmas morning level excitement of opening that box, chowing down on my fries and blackcurrant juice before ripping the plastic off my new Dash toy and watching it run across the table. And after all of that, I still had the burger, which I obviously took the pickles off and demolished. I grew up in a little country called New Zealand. Now, here in New Zealand, the McDonald's Happy Meal has always been a burger or chicken wrap, fries or apple slices, and blackcurrant juice or water. And a toy. I grew up with these options, you know? So to me, this is and always has been... That was not as cool as I thought it was gonna be. This is and always has been the Happy Meal. The truth is, of course, that there is no the Happy Meal. Every country has their own completely unique Happy Meal choices. I am not remotely embarrassed to admit that I have an encyclopedic knowledge of the weird and wonderful Happy Meals of the world. In fact, I have a list. I have a list of five countries, five Happy Meals that I desperately want to try. And the four-year-old in the back of my head says, Liam, pack your bags, baby. We are going on a month-long trip around the globe to complete this bucket list. The adult in the back of my head says, Liam, don't do this. This is a terrible financial decision.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
Now, I don't know about you guys, but if you ask me, there is only one acceptable place to start this adventure. And obviously I'm in New Zealand, but the United States. The flight doesn't leave for like 14 hours, so we're not actually in any rush. So about that no rushing thing, I may have left it a little bit late with the no rushing, and now I'm rushing. This is nothing out of the ordinary for me, so should be fine. Okay, I think we're good to go. So long, house. I'll see you on the other side. Ew, why is my suitcase sticky? Ugh, yuck. Ew, why is it sticky?
Welcome to LA, baby.
Wow, this is a nice bed, bro. I got a hotel room upgrade. I did not pay for this room, but I'm stoked. Now I know what you're thinking. Liam, did you only pick LA because you like movies? Wow. Rude. As if I would do that. Yes. Fortunately though, it turns out my selfish pick is pretty genius because supposedly the oldest running McDonald's
full stop, is right here in LA. We can eat a Happy Meal from the oldest running McDonald's. I mean, it probably tastes exactly the same. Obviously, it is a little bit late for our Happy Meal now, so I will probably do some really classic YouTuber abrupt cut from night to day.
Day.
Well, my dudes, it's a beautiful day to eat a Happy Meal.
I'll say that for free.
So my initial plan was to catch an Uber to this old McDonald's and old McDonald. Oh my God, that's funny. Anyways, it turns out Ubers cost the price of a small cat here. So
it also turned out to be the only convenient way to get there. So I paid my small cat. I took a hearty ride through LA and then.
Bro, this was transported straight out of the 1950s. Oh my God, it's so cool. Wow.
Hi, how you doing? Could I just grab a Happy Meal? Thanks so much. Much appreciated.
Goods have been acquired.
Well, 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 if it isn't the first Happy Meal of the adventure. I'm so hungry. I mean, thank God LA traffic's so good, otherwise it would have taken an hour to get back. Sarcasm. Okay, so it would obviously be a sin not to start with the hamburger. Very good bun. That is a better McDonald's bun than I've ever had in my life. The patty was very dry. Next, of course, we have the famous fries. No, I lost one. Still a good crisp after who knows how long. Now, this is fascinating. Apple slices, which means America has a double snack. In New Zealand, you only get one or the other. That's unheard of. I didn't know that they did that. Peeled slices. Very interesting. For the drink, we have literal milk, which is very strange to me. Oh. Probably shouldn't have drunk it that fast. And finally, we have our toy, Pokemon cards. Look, it's no Dash toy, but by modern standards, this is a solid toy. This is the kind of Happy Meal that you can't complain. The patty was very dry. You know, it's classic. It's everything you want an American Happy Meal to be. I'm gonna go ahead and give this a benchmark 7 out of 10. Now I have to go to another country.
Welcome to London, sir. It was very nice to have you. Yes.
I'm so jet lagged. So the good news about England is they have one of the most unbelievably weird Happy Meals I've ever seen. The bad news is they don't have a cool McDonald's to go to. So I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed. I'm going to scout out London over the next few days and try to find something.
Not a bad find. The goods have been acquired.
This is gonna be extremely, extremely interesting because right off the bat, before we've even taken a bite, the box is completely different. The box has a completely different opening mechanism. Fascinating. Now inside, we have the most English sandwich option I've ever seen. Fish fingers.
Good crunch. Let me just throw this out there. Those are really good.
For our snack, we have cucumber sticks.
I like cucumber sticks, bro. I'm just gonna...
Ooh. Oh my God, not these ones. Yeah, these are really slimy and bitter. And slimy? Why are they slimy? Hopefully we can redeem ourselves with the drink, which is more milk.
Hey.
And finally we have Dobble, which looks like some sort of spot the difference game. It's fine.
Ow.
Overall, I'm feeling, in the words of Pumbaa, slimy yet satisfied. Mostly slimy. I'm gonna go for a 4 out of 10. A strong 4 out of 10. It has felt like the longest journey of my life to get these first two Happy Meals. Probably because I did essentially have to travel to the other side of the world, but the good news is we are now on the other side of the world, right? In fact, we are in Europe. And the great thing about Europe is that we don't have to catch a plane every time we want a new Happy Meal. We can simply catch a train.
Oh, now that is an unbelievable bent flop.
So in addition to being home to, you know, Remy the Rat, Paris is supposedly home to a cool McDonald's, which I'm not sure when it became a requirement to go to a cool McDonald's, but you know what? It's what 4-year-old Liam would have wanted.
I feel like we've had way too many travel montages at this point, so I'm gonna do something really unbelievably original and cool. You ready for this? 3, 2, 1.
Hey!
This looks so good, bro. I mean, admittedly, they do have the English variety of box, which is just way more awkward to open and far, far less satisfying than the American one. Inside, however, I think is a different story because the Croc McDough? It appears to be some sort of ham and cheese toasted sandwich.
The Croc McDough. Croc Mc, don't miss out on that if you ever come to France. You know what I'm saying? That is really good, bro.
Next up for the snack is berry sorbet.
I mean, it's failsafe. What am I gonna say about sorbet? Have you ever had a sorbet and gone, ugh, yuck?
Obviously trust France to pull through with the double snack. I went out of pure curiosity for baby radishes.
I'm not sure about this, bro, but I'm gonna give it a crack and I'm gonna open my heart to the potential for this to be great. Oh, bro, that's cucumber level bad.
Now, as for the drink, I'ma have to deduct points here because while it is orange juice, it didn't fit in the box.
I'm not happy about that. I'm sad. Sad meal. Does everyone else scull the drinks or is that just me? That's good orange juice.
And finally for our toy, it looks like a puzzle.
A puzzle? Now we're talking. Now we're toyking. Joel, that is the happiest meal yet by a mile. Country mile. Which, why do they say, I don't understand why they say country mile. Wouldn't it take longer to do a mile in the city? Anyway.
I'm gonna have to go ahead and give this a 9 out of 10. Because, you know, while the self-imposed radish was a bit of a letdown, there is another option for potato wedges. So, keeping that in mind, this could have been a near perfect Happy Meal.
Hey, how's it going? So, as it is now... Okay, I don't need to whisper this quietly. It is midnight, and I'm whispering because the walls of this hotel are very thin, and I would feel slightly inconsiderate, you know.
Ah!
Now, if you are at all a Happy Meal scholar like myself, you will be familiar with the myth, the legend that is the Italian Happy Meal. Fortunately for us, Italy is very close to France. Hence why I bring this up now. TLDR, we're going to Italy, baby.
Running on about, wow, that's the worst bed yet. Rome, you let me down with the bed flop. Anyway, I'm literally running on about 3 hours sleep, but I'm also running on about 3 cappuccinos, so it's okay. Now, if my research doth not deceive me, Rome is home to one of the most majestical McDonald's in the world. Supposedly, it has a marble statue out the front.
Bro, my research doth not deceive me. This is so sick.
I'm just gonna go out there and fervently state this for the record. Is that the right word? I don't know. I think this could be a top spotter. First of all, and finally, we have another American-style box. Not only that, but the McToast appears to just be a crispier version of the Croc McDo.
Oh my god.
Yo.
Straight up, that's the best thing I've ever eaten from McDonald's.
That is phenomenal. Next we have baby carrots, which there's just no way these are bad.
Bro,
I'm done. But it doesn't end there, baby, because we are double snacking with a literal stick of Parmesan. I'm not just being dramatic. This is another 10. I mean, Parmesan from Italy, what do you expect? It's magical. Finally, and once again, we have orange juice, except this time, it fits in the box. Oh, and also Pokemon cards.
Oh, that's pretty good.
That's pretty good. I've never felt so close to crying over a Happy Meal in my life. That was so good. I didn't think it was gonna come down to this, but I see no alternative. This is a flawless Happy Meal. I have to give it a 10 out of 10. Maybe a 9.9 actually, because otherwise the last Happy Meal has no real chance. A 9.9 out of 10. So as well as taking the top spot, that Happy Meal, whoa. Wow, do not do that when you are lightheaded. That Happy Meal marks the second to last on our bucket list. We only have one more Happy Meal in this entire adventure. In other words, we've got a flight to catch. In like 6 days. I'm not gonna lie, I've spent about a week in each country because I don't know, I figured if I'm all the way over here, I might as well get the vibe, you know, purely for the video. I need to, you know, understand the country before I eat the Happy Meal. Believe this, but supposedly Japan does not have a weird McDonald's, which just doesn't, it doesn't feel right. I feel like there definitely should be, I don't know, a McDonald's that you go down a slide to get into it. Do you know what I mean? Apparently there's nothing. Okay. So, elephant in the room, it came in a paper bag. It did not come in a Happy Meal box. I'm not sure how I feel about the bag, but you know what I do feel about? That didn't make sense. Miniature pancakes. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Oh, it looks like there's a sauce too. What is that? Honey and mayonnaise, maybe? Oh, wow. Very interesting. Pouring experience.
Yo.
Yo. That's not mayonnaise. Our final snack is edamame and corn, which sounds quite frankly delicious.
Yo.
No, that's good. Oh, that's good. Obviously, I'm just the weird one, because it seems like milk is, oh wow, that is such a cool straw. Extendable straw. If there's anyone that can change my mind about milk, it's Japan. Bottoms up. Wow. Wow. That is completely different to the other two. It's sweet. A little bit. Almost buttery. That's good. Well, 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 if it isn't the final piece of the Happy Meal adventure, this toy is not my demographic. Just quietly, I would rather have a French puzzle. You know, it's cool that it's a real toy, but it just sits there. And that's it. Give me a puzzle. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, which Happy Meal takes the cake? I am gonna give Japan a 9.5 out of 10. Congratulations, Ashley! You are the unequivocal winner of this really arbitrary title that I made up, and it means nothing, but anyway, it took a month. That's that, I guess. Well, I have spent so long marveling over this Happy Meal that it is now completely dark. And there's actually a train going past. There's two trains going past. Wow, that is epic.
Whoops. That was fun.
I'm so jittery right now. I probably shouldn't have had 4 cappuccinos, but when in Rome, right?